Familiar faces now in a Yardbirds uniform include youthful manager Sip Garza, 23. Sip Garza managed the California City Whiptails in 2017. Meeting at the mound, Kyle Chavez, third baseman Bradley Harmon, shortstop Aaron Cook, second baseman Steve Longo, first baseman Shane Brown, and catcher Jake Marshall. Danny Diaz draws the start for skipper Sip Garza, the 6'2", former Cajon High School and Mount San Antonio College southpaw, starts off throwing strikes, disposing of the Amberjacks leadoff hitter on three pitches. Monterey puts a runner in scoring position with two outs. Danny Diaz gets out of the inning on the ground ball to second baseman Steve Longo. Steve Longo played for Sip Garza at California City last year. Among last year's Yardbirds, Dominic Zayer aboard with one out in the first. Dominic Zayer having been hit by a pitch. Fellow returning Yardbird Shane Brown with the first Yardbirds hit of the new season. Exhibition play, be that as it is. The Yardbirds load the bases. Dominic Zayer at third, Shane Brown at second, Kent Blackstone at first. He too having been hit by a pitch. The Amberjacks escape the bases loaded threat on the full count, borderline called strike three. End of one, no score. Danny Diaz gets the same call, though hitters have to learn the umpire's strike zone. As long as it is consistent, very few complain. Pecos League hitters soon learn this plate umpire, Keith Sabo, is as consistent as they come. Keith Sabo is chief umpire of the Pecos League. The Yardbirds draw first blood with a two-out rally in the fourth. Shane Castro slaps a single into center field. Shane Castro caught for Sip Garza's California City Whiptails last year. He's 24 out of Homestead, Florida. Bradley Harmon rockets the drive to deep right center field. Shane Castro running with two outs. He will dive head first across the plate and nearly experience a 2002 World Series moment when Dusty Baker's Giants bat boy, Dusty Baker's son, had to be plucked from the middle of the play at the plate by J.T. Snow. Shane Castro would have been 6 years old at that time, so he most likely could not relate to the comparison, but he surely is cognizant of the peril the bat boy placed himself in. It is Bradley Harmon with the first RBI of the ball game. 1-0 Yardbirds, end of four. Jake Marshall singles up the middle to open the fifth. The Arlington, Virginia rookie will soon be on third as the Yardbirds load the bases. Jake Marshall, 23-year-old left-handed hitting catcher, renewing acquaintances with Kieran Whitfield, fellow Pecos League rookie out of Hickory, North Carolina. At the plate, a returning hero of the 2017 championship team, Dominic Zayer, a regular on the Video Sports Action Highlights reports. Dominic Zayer goes with the pitch and dumps it into right field. Kieran Whitfield follows Jake Marshall across the plate. Demetrius Moore to third. Dominic Zayer's two-run single puts the Yardbirds up 3-0. Next time up, the Yardbirds, master of the highlights reel, drives it over the left field wall. The solo home run, putting High Desert up by 1-4-3 in the bottom of the eighth. And this is where we will end this report, in that the eventual outcome is entirely insignificant. This is but an exhibition game, seeing the Amberjacks explode for 9 in their ninth as the Yardbirds implode. Not the makings for this highlights reel. It will all be for real Sunday, May 27th, when the Yardbirds host Bakersfield to open 2018 Pecos League play and defense of their Pecos League title. This Welcome Back Yardbirds online video sports report is brought to you by the Community Table Restaurant in the Holiday Inn in Victorville, where every Thursday it's all-you-can-eat popcorn shrimp for just $9.95.